Hi all and welcome. I'll just have a bit of a rant about your perspective and I guess my perspective on society and how, what would you like society to look like? And this is all very general, generalized because society is so complicated, history is so complicated, so let's get into it. In this comment here, you can see the reference to India, but the, you know, within say the Hindu culture and within Buddhist cultures also, within the texts and all the rest of it, the information within those texts is not necessarily represented by the caste system, say, that heritage, that legacy from India. And the same would apply, say, with Christianity. If you know, say in England, for example, where you have the monarchy and you had the feudal system and the lords and all the rest of it. So this is a thing about, you know, people gaining power, you know, power to the little people of the land. Over there, of course, you had the Magna Carta in the 13th century and these sorts of things in England and, you know, progressions. So things have been much worse in the past. Imagine that. Imagine being in a society where it's really, really, you know, the dictatorship is really full on. I think in the past, and for much of the past, over much, you know, of the thousands of years and so forth, that it's possibly been a lot worse. In the society that we live in today, we have a reasonable amount of liberties, and I know there's a lot of shit going on, for sure. Corruption, it's crazy, but at the same time, there is a certain amount of liberty there. And I put forth that if you look at countries like America and Australia and other such countries in Canada and these sorts of places, and you look at things, the Freemasons have had a lot to do with it. The Freemasons are very complicated, you know, they're right into the monarchy also, but at the same time they kind of separate themselves from the monarchy also. There's this strange, you know, with the City of London and the passing of the Queen into the City of London and the monarchy and the strange relationship over there in England. And then you had, you know, the Freemasons really, for the most part, setting America up with the Constitution and these sorts of things, and bringing, you know, being quite responsible for bringing about a country like America. So would you rather live in a society run by, say, this is a tough one, Christians, because these literalist Christians just dominate. This is the way that your average kind of Joe just picks things up. It's just almost this like completely literal view of the Bible, and that's just the way it is. These occult documents, that's the way they're kind of sucked up and understood by people. And so would you trade the society that we have today for a society that would be run by these kind of literalist Christians, for example? Or, you know, and then I guess you have the Jewish aspect as well, and the you know, with the so-called Abrahamic religions and Islam. But mainly, I live in a Western country, mostly it's supposedly Christian and all the rest of it, and the same with America. And that's, so you just get inundated with the sort of stuff, the indoctrination. And so that question, would you rather live, and this is an honest question, please be honest about it, and it might be a bit hard for people to take, but how do you feel about society, or how would you run it? And when you see all these literalist Christians, well, would you like to live in a society where they run the show? And yet further, and this is just out of interest in a way, and in the context of the truth movement, where I virtually never see any credit given to the Freemasons, can you give credit to the Freemasons in any way?